Okay, hello everyone. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I will be on my own today. Dr. John Thomas got caught up in some tasks today, but today I'm really excited to be talking to you because this is right up my line of work as the adrenal fatigue recovery ninja. I deal with patients that have hormonal imbalances. They don't balance their stress response very well. They're exhausted, they're burnt out, they don't focus, they crash in the middle of their day. Circadian rhythms are broken, their monthly cycles are off, or the males are aromatizing and they are emotional and they're just not dealing with stress very well. So today we want to talk about your genetic type and the hormone imbalance genetic type, because we have 7 genetic types and we find that based on your genetic testing, people will do an MTHFR test only by their doctor, and then they say, I don't have MTHFR, or I do have MTHFR, and how does that relate to my chief complaints? And my chief complaints can be a bunch of stuff, but in today's episode of your genetic type, we are talking about the hormone imbalance type. So what I want to do is I want to share with you a presentation that Dr. John Thomas and I prepared together, and we can get into this. So I'm going to share this with you guys right now, and this is where we are, and we're going to be talking about the hormone imbalanced type, the hormone imbalanced genetic type. So first and foremost, if you haven't subscribed to our Your Genetic Type mini course, make sure that you go to yourgenetictype.com, and in the resources section in the upper right hand of the page, you will see that there is a free mini course that you can take, and it will let you know what your genetic type is. And you may have multiple genetic types. So we have a lot of people that are overstimulated and understimulated, or they're weak cellular, or they have a decreased capacity for producing energy, or they have a weak immune, they're always sick, they're toxic accumulators, or they have a histamine intolerance. So depending on the way that you answer those questions and what you're feeling based on our mini course will be determining what your specific genetic type is. So let's get into the hormone imbalance type. So the hormone imbalance genetic type are those that suffer with fatigue. They have mood regulation issues. So they get stressed out. They tend to have more mood or less mood at different parts of their cycle, difficulty losing weight. And typically this is confirmed through even blood testing, saliva testing, Dutch testing, some form of problem with the feedback of potentially the pituitary and FSH or LH, or your progesterone or estrogen. Potentially these are women that have had endometriosis or fibroids or PCOS or problems with the cycle, having to be put on birth control, being put on synthetic birth control, taking antibiotics and things like spironolactone only complicate the matter. And we find a lot of the times with the people that we work with, I use the analogy of a golf pro. And what I say is that not only am I teaching you a swing to swing a club and hit the ball, you know, a certain distance and make it go straight and far and accurate. I also have to now unlearn the bad swinging mechanics that you had and relearn good swinging mechanics, which is a lot harder than just teaching someone who's never swung a club before how to swing the club properly from the first time versus, hey, your habits are so crappy, I gotta unlearn those and relearn a new swing. The analogy is such that when you have been doing a bunch of different things to help your health, which the doctor thought was the right thing to do, it's like unlearning a bad swing. So we got to learn what impact did taking the hormones or taking birth control that was synthetic or taking so much what we call exogenous hormones, where you're getting it from the outside, where you're just overpowering your body and you create like a hormone resistance, or you create a buildup of disruptors and endocrine chemicals that ultimately now we have a lot of work to do beyond just why you had to go on those hormones in the first place. And we find a lot of the time, if you're a hormonal imbalanced genetic type, we got our hands full. And a lot of the times, like we said, we don't find a genetic type that usually occurs by itself. So typically it's compounded by the fact that you may be a toxic accumulator, or you may have a weak cellular, or you're a histamine-based type. It's just making things worse. But ultimately, people that have difficulty balancing their hormones, they don't respond traditionally to the care that their primary doctor is providing. And even alternatively, like they'll try DHEA or pregnenolone, or they'll try DIM or things that help clear things out, but ultimately they're stuck and they're not moving the needle. So what I wanted to talk about is the common symptoms that we see with someone that's a hormonal imbalanced genetic type. So we see things like we said earlier, excessive fatigue, or their difficulty with losing weight no matter how much they exercise, PMS, so different parts of the cycle, very irritable, different parts of the cycle very well. And the menstrual cycle is irregular. It's too long, it's too short, it's long and then short. There's potentially excessive facial hair, so they have excess androgens, PCOS-like symptoms, and even males will have the aromatizing of their testosterone. And it's really interesting, you know, we look at it where you see when someone has major inflammation and environmental triggers, the genders degenderify, if that's a word. What happens is you'll see guys when they're inflamed, their testosterone will aromatize. And then women, when they're inflamed, they will have excess androgens. And it's really interesting how the body does that. But ultimately, that person would be a hormonal type person where their genetic type may be more susceptible for hormonal imbalances. And wouldn't you like to know that? Wouldn't you like to know, like, okay, I didn't just do a MTHFR test that the doctor wrote for me and told me I was fine, but I actually did a nutrigenomic test. And I looked at the particular gene SNPs and I found that I have the main common genes where they're altered, where dad passed me down a copy or mom passed me down a copy and I have one copy that's called heterozygous, or mom and dad passed me down the copies and now I have a homozygous SNP. And basically in English, when that happens, you're not replicating or regenerating that enzyme effectively. And that enzyme is very important. Like that enzyme will help transport hormones across the body, or that enzyme will help break down hormones so they're not partially metabolized, and then what they do is it's not being cleared out by the body and then it's recirculating in the body, and it will bind to different receptors and it will take the place of other hormones that are more effective, and now you have some binding sites that those hormones should have been activating in a proper way. It's a partially metabolized hormone and it really mucks up the binding sites. We see that happen a lot. And then on top of that, if you're taking a lot of exogenous synthetic or even bioidentical hormones, now we're that golf pro having to relearn and unlearn that swing of what you're already doing. Hopefully that made a lot of sense to you guys. And we see that a lot. Unfortunately, I can't answer your question specifically in this Facebook Live because we're doing it through Zoom. But if you are watching this and you have questions, make sure you put it in the feed what your specific questions are so that Dr. John and I can go back there and answer your questions. We'll also see loss of libido. That's very, very common. I get that very common from both men and women that say to me that their spouse is frustrated. They don't understand. They just think I should get better. I have no drive and no libido. And that's really taking an impact on our marriage. Marriage and our relationship. We see that very, very commonly. Also fatiguing after a meal. So there could be some insulin resistance because there's inflammation going on. ongoing adrenal fatigue. You know, we see this more as maladaptive adrenals, where you have good days and you have bad days. Your free fraction of the hormone is low and it's not getting into the cell, or your free fraction of the hormone is high and it is causing over resistance to that hormone and creating major problems. Ongoing thyroid problems. This is where we see the hormonal imbalance type. So people play whack-a-mole a lot of time when it comes to supporting their thyroid. They're not even listening to their symptoms. They're testing and treating a number, and they'll say, hey, my TSH is in a certain range, so that should be fine. Or I just keep taking more and more TSH, or taking thyroid hormone and Armour and Synthroid and W thyroid, and I take all these different things because I don't care what my TSH is. I just care what my T3 and my T4 is, even though I feel like I'm going out of my mind. I have heart palpitations. I have night sweats. I'm overstimulated. And my doctor's treating my number. Again, when we see these type of people and we run a genetic test on them, we're not only learning and looking at what are their susceptibilities and what are their genetic types, but what am I needing to unlearn as well as relearn? And a lot of the time, that's what you need to look at is did I commensurate my improvements with my dosing strategies? And I'll say that one more time. Did I commensurate my improvements with my dosing strategies? In English, what that means is, as I get better, do I change around the prescriptions or the supplements that I was taking at the time when I was worse? And now that I'm improving, I don't need them as much anymore, because my body is producing more energy on its own, and I'm able to now get more gas mileage out of the fuel injector, and I don't have to necessarily go back to the gas station frequently because my car is more efficient. That's a really, really important distinction that I think a lot of people forget, and they say, oh, this isn't working. I'm not getting better. You are getting better. You just got the pounding of the gavel and the judge said, I hereby sentence you for a life term of taking this and that, and not realizing, hey, your body has the ability to heal. And I always tell people, if you look at a set of lungs that have been smoked upon for 50 years and you stop smoking and you put good nutrients and good energy and good, you know, frequency in the body, all of a sudden your body, not overnight, but your body develops a whole brand new set of lungs. So your body's very resilient, very forgiving. And I really want to encourage the hope and the ability to get better, because your body certainly can get better provided you look at the proper things that you need to look at. Cysts in the breasts and ovaries, estrogen cancers, estrogen dominance. Actually, one important thing I wanted to tell you is that when you do a Dutch test, we can look at the metabolites of estrogen. So if you're concerned about taking pregnenolone or taking DHEA and it spills over into estrogen and you had estrogen cancer and you don't want to have any elevation of your estrogen metabolites, I think that you need to reconsider that, because things like chase tree and really your isoflavonoids, Don Quay, and other nutrients that can support your estrogen production is necessary, because you need a certain amount of estrogen to function. And a lot of people will throw the baby out with the bathwater and say, okay, we can't give you any estrogen support, it's bad. But meanwhile, you're okay to take like a synthetic, you know, Premarin or, you know, anyways, I digress. So here are these particular gene SNPs that we want you to look at when you're a hormone imbalance type. You have the vitamin D receptor, which is really important for hormone, your sex hormone binding globulin, which is impacted by estrogen and testosterone, which allows your hormones to be transported across the body and into the cell. Your COMT, which is really important for clearing out estrogen, which is dependent on MTHFR. And then you have your CYP enzymes, which are your liver enzymes, which are again important for clearing out estrogens, because if you're not clearing them out, like I said, you have these partially metabolized hormones that are binding to receptors that aren't allowing your good hormones to get into the cell effectively. And it's really mucking up the waters. And CYP enzymes are very iron dependent. So if you have some iron issues, which are part of our pyramid, like if you look at this pyramid here, what Dr. John and I teach is that, hey, you got priorities where if you're not clearing out histamine, if you're not transporting iron, if you're not making your antioxidants, if you're not supporting your production of antioxidants, if you're not supporting your acetylation and your burning of protein and fats, if you're not breaking down your tissues and recycling them to be repurposed, if you're not doing those things and you have these particular types of gene SNPs, then you're more than likely going to show as a hormone imbalance type, and you're going to have loss of libido, endometriosis, breast, cystic breasts, polycystic, irregular menstrual cycles. And then what are we doing to fix that? We are putting people on hormones for the rest of their life, or birth control, or they're trying to restore their youthful ages when they're in their 70s, and their liver, their methylation, their iron oxidation, their histamines, they're not being controlled. And then the weak link in that genetic type's chain is going to be the hormone imbalance. And again, hopefully that made a lot of sense. What do we recommend for this? What do we do? Well, number one, the first thing we do is we want to know what our genetic type is. So you go to yourgenetictype.com and make sure that you check out those free resources and log into the 7 mini series, video series that you get to learn your genetic type. We will be updating that with a test that you can just take and you fill out, and it will make a lot easier for you. But for now, there is a test that you can score and then figure out on your own. But then we also have your genetic type unlocked, where it's our $97 course that has over 12 hours of training that explains to you what can you do about this. And if you have your genetic type is a hormone imbalance type, then we get into, hey, these are the best tests that you can do. And a really good test is going to be the Dutch test, where you're going to look at your cortisol, your free cortisol, your estrogen metabolites, your E1, your E2, your E3, your testosterone, your androgens, how well is your phase one being used in terms of breaking down your estrogens. Maybe you're going down a more oxidizing DNA damaging pathway, which would predispose you for estrogen-like cancers. And we really need to support that with, say, some DIM or some sulforaphane or other things that we can do to really help that. But that would be a great test, so that your genetic type tells you about what are the best tests for your specific gene SNPs, what are the gene SNPs that you need to be worried about that you may have yourself, that you can say, hey, I'm this genetic type or that genetic type. What are the best supplements that you can use to help support that particular genetic type, but also not be on it for the rest of your life, right? We don't want to just continue to give you support and not realize that we have to commensurate the improvement levels. Now, with that being said, if you have a specific genetic type, you may have the predisposition to always need that liver support, right? Because you have the COMT and you have the CYP enzymes. You always are going to have those enzymes, but it's a matter of taking, as Dr. John and I talk about, taking the epigenetic stressors out of the equation, or getting the cars off the highway so that you don't put pressure on those gene SNPs in the first place. So you have to take those supplements for the rest of your life. Or you can change around your dosing strategies when there's less cars on the highway, your hormones are balanced, your mood is balanced, your libido is balanced, your weight loss is coming off, you're not having irregular cycles, you have motivation, you feel lots of oomph, and you feel like you have some vitality, then you know, hey, I'm doing a good job here. So that's what your genetic type is all about. So once again, go to yourgenetictype.com, check out our free resources, make sure that you log into the free mini course, and really think about taking the Your Genetic Type Unlocked course, which is a $97 course. And what we're doing is we're launching our membership site. So when you purchase the $97 course, you'll get a free trial for a month to our membership site where Dr. John and I will be doing case studies. So he has a very busy practice and I have a very busy practice. We see people that have all of these different seven genetic types all the time. And what we want to do is have you look over our shoulder and say, hey, here's how we figured out what their genetic type was. They had three or four different genetic types, but here was the priority. Here's the gene SNPs that they have that validates or corroborates that they're this genetic type. Here's the different tests that we recommended on this patient, and these were the results of the test. Here's the supplements that we were taking already, and we said, hey, you don't need to be on 1,001 different things. We need to fine tune it to these three or four different things. But here's some supplements that you need to be taking that you're not, that can really support that genetic type. And then here's the different dietary recommendations, and here's the outcome. And that's invaluable because to learn this stuff is really, really difficult. Dr. John and I do this every day in practice, and we're constantly learning this and constantly updating our algorithms or our formulas to make it more customized to each and every client that we work with. But we know you need the help that you're not getting. But at the same time, you've paid an arm and a leg for a bunch of different things. And you know, there's a genetic component that you're missing out on. What better to have two nerds like Dr. John and I to be able to basically take you by the hand and do the membership component. So that's going to be available starting this month. We're gonna have a case study every other week. So in the second week of November and the last week of November. And then in our membership site, we will be amassing all our lives. So we'll categorize that. We'll put it under different genetic types, under different topics, so that when you go into the membership site, all of those tools and the PDFs and the videos will be in there for you guys to access. So it's really an awesome deal. It's $97, like I said, to be able to purchase the first product. And then from there, you get a free trial. I think we're going to do a $1 trial for the membership site. And then from there, I think we're going to probably do like a $19 a month continuity program where for $19, you get to meet with Dr. John and I two times a month and have access to all of those libraries of indexing of all the different genetic types and videos and PDFs that we produce for you. So hopefully that is going to be very, very well received. Let me know what questions you guys have, how we can support you, what topics you'd like to hear us talk about, what some of your biggest challenges are, so that we can really design our programs around your specific needs. So hopefully you got a lot out of today's hormonal imbalance genetic type. It usually doesn't occur by itself. It usually has some toxic accumulation or histamine-based types, or weak cellular, or weakened immune, or has those things that are going on at the same time. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you need to go head over to yourgenetictype.com and log into that free section of the website, and then make sure that you do go and get that $97 introductory course, which we're going to be starting our membership site this month. So anyways, from Dr. John Thomas and myself, we are here to support you. We are looking to end your genetic type nightmare, and we look forward to giving you support in the future. Hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day. Take care.